Welcome students, today we will discuss a topic that comes under the function. Our today's topic is mapping of functions. Students, let I have a function that is defined from set A to set B. Okay, now let us take some elements in set A. This is diagrammatic form of set A, and this is diagrammatic form of set B. Okay, this is set A and this is set B. Let set A has some element that are x1, y1, x2, x3. And set B has some element that are y1, y2, y3. Okay students, now we know that the function is a special type of relation in which each element of set A is associated to unique element of set B. Okay, now we can associate the elements of A to be in many ways. We can associate x1 with y1, x2 with y2, or x1 and x2 both to y1. On the basis of these combination, different type of combination, functions are classified in different type of mapping. Here we will discuss our four important mappings that are one-one mapping or one-one function. Next one will be many-one function. Third one will be onto. Fourth one will be into. And fifth one will be combination of one-one and onto. That is known as one-one onto or bijective. So we should discuss here different type of mappings for function. Okay students, these mappings depend that how the elements of set A are associated to element of set B. Okay, so we should discuss first one-one mapping. One-one mapping. Students, let us take set A and set B here. Say A has some elements that are x1, x2, x3, and set B has elements y1, y2, y3, and y4. Okay? And let function define that x1 is associated to y1, x2 is associated to y2. X3 is associated to I2. Here we saw in this representation that different element of set A have different unique images. X1 has unique image Y1, X2 has unique image Y2, X3 has unique image Y3. If different element of set A is associated to different unique element of set B, then this type of mapping is known as one-one mapping. This is one-one mapping. Now this is diagrammatic form of one-one mapping. Now we should know that how mapping is calculated in any problem, that how we decide that any given function is one-one or not. So we will discuss here three methods to identify one-one mapping methods to check one-one mapping. Okay students, our first method is algebraic method. In algebraic method, we should consider two elements we should consider two elements x and y which belongs to our domain. X and y which belongs to our domain are we can take two elements x1 and x2 which belongs to our domain, and we should select fx1 is equal to fx2. After that, if we get that x1 is equal to x2, then we can say that function is 1-1, because if we have selected two different element of domain that are x1 and x2, and let their images are equal, then elements should also equal. If their images are equal and elements are equal, so it defines that we have selected here initially two elements, and after solving them we got that there are not two actual elements, that elements are single element x1 because these are equal. Okay, if elements are unique, then their images are also unique. Okay students, so if we take fx1 equal to fx2, then we should get that x1 equal to x2. Now we can say that function or mapping is 1-1 mapping. Okay, now we should discuss second method, that is our geometrical method. Geometrical method are we can okay, let us take geometrical method or graphical methods, we can say graphical method also. Students, in this case we should draw the graph of fx, we should draw the graph of fx on xy plane. Okay, if let us consider that we get graph something this. Okay students, consider for example that we have got the graph of fx in such way. We should now draw the horizontal line. If this horizontal line cuts the graph at single point, then our given function will be 1-1 mapping or 1-1 function. Okay, if horizontal line cuts the graph only at single point, then our given function will be 1-1 function or 1-1 mapping. Okay, as in this case of example here, horizontal line cuts the graph only at single point A, so this function fx will be unique function. If horizontal line cuts the graph at more than one point, then mapping will not one-one mapping. Okay, so it is geometrical or graphical method. Now we should discuss our third method, that is calculus method. Now we should discuss calculus method, that is our third method to check 1-1 function. Okay students, our third method is calculus. In this method, let we have a function fx. In this method, we differentiate the function f dash x. If it is greater or equal to 0, or f dash x less or equal to 0 for all x belonging to domain. For all x belonging to domain, if f dash x is either x greater or equal to 0 or less or equal to 0, then function will be 1-1 function, or then function will be 1-1 function. Or we can say that if any function is either one function is monotonic. If any function is monotonic, monotony means either increasing or decreasing. Monotony means either increasing or decreasing. Then we can say that given function is what? One function. So we have discussed here three methods to identify the one mapping. Our first method is algebraic method, in which we take two elements from set A and we should put their images are equal, then elements should be also equal. Our second method was geometrical method or graphical method. In this method, we should draw the graph of given function and now draw the horizontal line that is a parallel to x axis. If horizontal line cuts the graph at single point, then our given function is one function. And third method is calculus method. In this method, we differentiate the function. If differentiation is either greater or equal to 0 or less or equal to 0, in other way we can say that if function is monotonic, that is either increasing or decreasing, then given function will be one mapping function. Now we should discuss another type of mapping. Here one element has only one unique image. Okay friends, now we should discuss another type of mapping, that is many one. What is many one mapping? Simply we can say that if any function is not one, then it will be many one mapping function. Okay, if any function is not one mapping function, then that function will be many one mapping function. In another way, we can say that if elements of set A, if more than one element of set A have single image in set B, then that function will be many one function. For many one function, we should draw here that images of x1 and x2 are same, that is y1. This is example of many one function, because here images of x1 and x2 are same, that is y1. So this is the representation of many one function. Okay friends, this is representation of many one function. Now we should check the many one function. So here no need of discussion two methods, because we have discussed the method in one function. In it we have discussed three methods. If all our three methods are failed, then that function will be many one function. As we can say that if any function after checking is not one, then that function will be many one function. So we should not discuss here methods to check many one function, because here are same process to check many one and one function. Now we should discuss a topic that is the number of functions. That is, we should discuss that how many number of one and many one. Okay, so students, let A have n elements and B have n elements, small n elements. Then we know that total number of function, total number of function from A to B is equal to what? N e power m. Okay, now we should discuss number of one mapping. Number of one mapping. What is number of one mapping? It depends on number of elements in set A and set B. That is, it can be NPM in what cases? When n greater or equal to m, if n is greater or equal to m, meaning number of elements in set B is either greater or equal to number of elements in A, then number of one-one mapping will be NPM, n permutation m. Okay, and if n is less than m, then number of one-one mapping will be zero. Okay, now we should discuss number of many-one mapping. Number of many-one mapping for data. To get number of many-one mapping, we should subtract the number of one-one mapping from the total number of mapping. That is, if n greater or equal to m, then number of many-one mapping will be n the power m minus np m, and if n is less than m, then n the power m minus 0 will be n the power m. Okay friends, this is number of many-one mapping, and this is number of one-one mapping, and this is total number of mapping. So we have discussed two types of mapping, that is one-one and many-one, and also we have discussed that how many number of mappings are possible and methods to check the type of mapping. Now we should discuss another type of mapping. Our next type of mapping is onto mapping. Okay friends, we should discuss now onto mapping. Onto mapping means, as we can see here, that element y4 and y2 have no pre-images. Elements are set B, that are y2 and y4 have no pre-image. Means y2 and y4 are not associated to any element of set A. If B avoid this situation, means if there is no element in set B that is not associated to set A, then that function will be, or that mapping will be onto mapping. Means if we associate all elements of set B with elements of set A, then that type of mapping will be onto mapping. In this representation, a mapping from A to B is onto mapping because there is no element in set B which is not associated to set A. Every element of set A and set B are associated to each other. Okay friends, so this type of mapping is known as onto mapping because no element in set B is empty, or we can say there is no element in set B which is not associated to element of set A. So this is onto mapping. Now we should discuss on very important condition of onto mapping. For onto mapping, range is always equal to codomain. This is the must condition of onto mapping. If range is equal to codomain, then that mapping should part onto mapping. So now we should discuss number of onto mapping. We have discussed here one-one and many-one mapping numbers. Now we should discuss onto mapping numbers. Number of onto mapping. Students, we should know another name of onto mapping, that is surjective mapping. This is also known as surjective mapping. Then number of onto or surjective mapping is equal to what? We should discuss here three conditions. When n is less than m, when less than m, then number of anti-mapping will be sigma k is equal to 0 to n minus 1 to power k n c k n minus k to power m. Okay students, this will be number of onto mapping. What? This will be number of onto mapping if situation n is less than m. If n is equal to m, then number of onto mapping will be factorial n. Okay, factorial n. If n is equal to m, then number of onto mapping will be what? Factorial n. In another case, if n is greater than m, then number of onto mapping will be 0. Okay friends, remember this point, remember these points. If n is less than m, number of mapping will be in this sigma form. N equal to m, then number of mapping will be factorial n. If n is greater than m, then number of mapping will be 0. Okay. Now we should discuss another type of mapping, that is into mapping. Into mapping. What is into mapping? We should know. If any mapping is not onto, then that mapping will be known as into mapping. Means, if any element of set B is not associated to set A element, then that particular mapping will be into mapping. In this case, range is not equal to codomain. Okay students, so this type of mapping is known as what? This type of mapping is known as into mapping. Now question arises to know number of into mapping. What is the number of into mapping? So in this case, if n is less or equal to m, then number of into mapping will be, here we should start k from 1. In onto mapping start k from 0, and in into mapping start k from 1 and up to n. And when n is greater than m, the number of mapping will be that is n e power m minus 0, that will be n e power m. Okay students, so this is the our number of into mapping formula. Okay friends, now we should discuss another mapping, that is our next type of mapping is 1-1 onto mapping. What? 1-1 onto. That is bijective. This is bijective mapping. Okay friends, this mapping is known as bijective mapping also. As we know that this mapping is constructed from two types of mapping combination, that is 1-1 and onto mapping. Means in this mapping both conditions will be satisfied, that are 1-1 mapping condition and onto mapping condition. In 1-1 mapping condition, we know that each element of set is associated to unique element of set B and different element of set A should be associated to different element of set B. And for onto mapping, no element of set B is empty. Means if we remove Y4 from here, then this mapping will be 1-1 as well as onto mapping. For so in this case, mapping should be 1-1 as well as onto mapping. Then we will say that particular mapping is 1-1 onto mapping. Okay students, So students, in this particular session we have discussed types of mappings. We have discussed here total 5 mappings that are 1-1 mapping, many-one mapping, onto mapping, into mapping, 1-1 onto mapping, and how many mappings are created in different situations. We have discussed their formulas also. So this was very interesting session in big point of view of mapping and how many mappings can be created in different situations.